Let's go. All right. Classic. One of my favorite records. Mr. C, R.I.P. One of my favorite Kane records, period. That's it. That is my shit.
For what?
That's fine, man. That's fine. We like the size clothes that we wear. You know, the hip-hop shit, man. Anyway, let's talk about Mr. C real briefly. I don't know a ton about Mr. C. R.I.P. to dude. I've definitely heard of him, without a doubt. He's just one of those people that, if you're into hip-hop, there's kind of no way you wouldn't have heard of him. So, I'm trying to remember the first time I heard of Mr. C. You know, it might sound crazy, but obviously the time to me when... I mean, I would hear little things, Mr. C, here and there with Big or whatever. The few times when I listened to Hot 97. Now, you have to remember, I didn't really live in New York until the late 2010s or whatever. So I wasn't necessarily listening to New York radio, right? But those, of course, who did live in the tri-state area and lived in New York probably heard Mr. C all the time. But I definitely heard of him. And of course, in particular, when the whole transsexual issue came out, wow, like, it feels like it was 15 years ago now. I don't even remember how long, but it was a while ago. And he got exposed from, I guess he was getting top or something from someone transsexual. And it turned into, it was, you know, this is before, I'm laughing because I'm like, damn, Mr. C, he's lucky, you know, he was unfortunate. This is right before Me Too and all that, like, victimhood chic and everything, you know, because he could have, like, just a couple of years after, he could have played that card and been like, look, listen, man, like, y'all are hating on me because I like transsexuals or whatever, which is true. I mean, it was hateful. I mean, look, at the end of the day, I don't give a fuck, like, who you mess with. Again, I've always said, like, it's all about consent at the end of the day, right? Like, you know, do what you gotta do. And frankly, like, if I was into transsexuals, I would tell you. Or if you found me doing this shit, I'd be like, yeah, I'm into transsexuals and what? Like, you know what I'm saying? Who gives a shit? Like, but of course, you know, people who are often homophobic or scared of their own sexuality, they want to project that onto other people. I don't have time for that, man. So, and look, listen, for those of y'all who want to take this and run with it, I mean, I'm straight. You will never see me with another dude necessarily. But again, that's just, most people are, they say sexuality is a spectrum. Most people are probably heteronormative, as they say, or heterosexual, and then there's others who are not, and that's totally fine. Again, I always think that you got to respect people, like, what people do in their bedroom is up to them, you know what I mean? So, like I said, if I were gay, I, you know, what's it to you? Like, you know what I'm saying? I would proudly tell you, that's just me, but... You know, I never really liked how people came at Mr. C. I thought it was pretty corny to me personally, but that's just how it is. You know, like, you're talking about a closeted culture. A lot of it is, of course, due to religion that closets their, that sexuality represses it. So you're talking about religion, which represses heterosexual behavior, not to talk about, obviously, homosexual and other, bisexual and all the spectrums of sexuality. They go extra hard on that shit. So, yeah, I did think it was unfortunate. It's interesting, of course, now that he's passed, everyone's like, yo, I love Mr. C, and Mr. C is my man, and, you know, blah, blah. And, of course, I'm sure there's a lot of those tributes that are real, right? Shout out to my man Gemini, the gifted one, who knew Mr. C personally. A lot of, there are people who know him personally and say he was a good dude, and I'm sure their tributes are genuine. But of course, there's always fake people who will say, just to be like, oh, I was around Mr. C, I'm special in hip-hop because I knew him. They were probably the same people, you know, hating on him because of his whole sexuality reveal and stuff like that. But that's how things are. Human beings, unfortunately, can be very fake about those kind of things. It's just the nature of the game. But RIP to Mr. C. He apparently was a big supporter of Mobb Deep early, And that's a great thing. You know, like DJs and DJ culture, I don't talk about it as much because I have to say that my knowledge on DJs is limited. You know, I've tried to DJ myself, like just like I bought like a little like a board and tried it. It's tough. I respect the hell out of anyone who can DJ. It's not easy at all. So, you know, I bought, you know, DJ tapes. I was obviously a Clue fan and a Primo and all that stuff. So I do know some things, but there's a lot I don't know about the DJs. But I do know that they are the ones that make hip-hop tick in a lot of ways, right? Like, I've been at clubs and heard certain records because the DJ was playing them, and I went, wow, I've never heard the song, but I really like the song, and it put me onto a certain artist or whatever. And that was back in the day when DJs had taste. That's why DJs are important. They're the ones that determine in a lot of ways. It's good to know DJs because they have a read of the crowd, and they can tell you and say, hey, you know, this record you just made, I don't know if it'll work. Or, yo, it might really work, right? So, anyway. R.I.P. to Mr. C. Now, let's get into the meat and potatoes of why you clicked here, of course. Talking about, you know, the illustrious J. Cole. I'll let Prodigy say it best, because I think Prodigy spoke on this, ironically, decades before J. Cole even started rapping or became a thing. One of these actresses, and they're trying to play the man's role. Of course, that's J. Cole. And then my favorite also, this is for J. Cole stands. Like, I looked up to turned out to be suspect. Yeah, people you looked up to turned out to be suspect. I mean, this is the truth of the matter. J. Cole was always suspect. I mean, he's a phony rapper. I knew this back then. You know what I mean? This is not hard to, it's not hard to see. It's interesting now because obviously some J. Cole stans are sitting there going like, oh my God, like, how could he apologize? Like, he's been rapping about how he's that dude all this time and he just backs away. Yeah, because he's reading a script. You know what I mean? You know how many whack niggas I gotta put up with in the last 20 years? And as a hip hop fan, I could tell that these they're whack as shit from day one. J. Cole was always whack to me. You know what I mean? He's a perfect example of how this game became fucked up. It's just branding and shit. You know what I mean? When he came out with that Return of Simba or whatever that song was, he was walking down an alleyway or something. I was like, this is the corniest shit I've ever heard in my life. And then he became this legendary big three rapper. Get the fuck out of here, man. I see the J. Cole sponsored damage control that's going on. Hot 97 in particular, your man Rosenberg. I couldn't watch all of it because it was just offensive to me, honestly. But, you know, Rosenberg tries to set up an argument. Of course, the worst arguments are the ones that take elements of truth and then twist it into something that is entirely fake and manufactured. So, Rosenberg early says, look, genres evolve when someone prominent in that genre does something bold. This is very true. When you have someone that people know very well and then they like, again, let's look at a perfect example. Look at Aaliyah, right? Aaliyah, when she started fucking with Timbaland and Missy, was already a star, right? So she had already come out with R. Kelly's music, like sort of R. Kelly style production on her first album. She was a star. Right? But she decided and was like, you know, I'm going to go something completely untested, right? This Missy Elliott, you know, Timbaland shit that's like some new shit. I've never heard anything like this, but I just like it. I fuck with it. Again, Aaliyah had taste, which is why we really liked her. And I'm just going to do that and do something bold. And that's how the genre evolved. She came out with some new shit that everyone went, oh my God, I love this. Like, something about the sound is so unique and captivating. And then you started seeing people, 702, Destiny's Child, a whole bunch of people that started to bite that sound. So, yes, that's very true. But the thing is, what Rosenberg is trying to say is that, well, you know, J. Cole is being so bold as to step down from the battle because it's beef or whatever. And that we, as hip-hop heads, are actually old heads stuck in the past who are keeping hip-hop from evolving. You see, that's that bullshit. That's that vulture shit that Rosenberg be coming up with. And you know what, man? Let's just call it what it is. It's 2024, okay? Like, when I see people like Rosenberg talk, to me, Rosenberg seems like an agent. And I've met Rosenberg, okay? So I've literally met the dude, right? I've met him at Central Park. There was, I think, the Originals had a show. This was Clark Kent, Stretch Armstrong, This was like maybe 5 years ago. And the one thing that always stuck out to me about Rosenberg is they're playing all these hard hip-hop classics, the Locks and all the stuff that Rosenberg says he likes, but Rosenberg was, I'm literally standing right behind the dude, and he was there with his other white friend, and neither of them were even paying attention to the music, dancing, none of that shit. They were just chatting, you know, to him, to their boys. Now, again, that's a snapshot. You know, he could have, you know, Rosenberg's someone that I'm sure he's a radio guy. He gets invited to a lot of stuff. You know, again, I'm willing to say that that's a one-off. There might be someone he hasn't seen in a really long time, and they've got to catch up and all that stuff. So the music isn't so important. I get it, okay? But I am also saying that as somebody that is just getting a one snapshot, right? I'm looking at this dude like, do you even like this music, or you're just here, right? So when I see your opinion, and your opinion is telling me about how beef is toxic, and you know it takes a strong person, you know, and then you start trying to unravel, like, well, why are we even talking about people who are supposedly number one in rap? You know, there was never a thing about there was never that guy in hip hop. There was never a when Big or Nas was number one. And it's just like, whoa. See, this is what vultures do. They just try to like do they'll disrespect and unravel old shit. Old classic shit to defend new garbage that's clearly not even hip-hop. So anyway, I do think obviously that Cole didn't do anything bold at all. He's never been bold a day in his life. He literally just backed down from a battle after, again, it's not that Cole was sitting there and decided, you know, was thinking about doing a diss record and then fell back, and you know, then we went, oh, you can't do that. Cole has been talking this hot shit for his entire career. Yo, I'm nice. I'm nice with the pen. I'll smash you. I'll take any battle that comes. All this shit, blah, blah. He's been talking that hot shit. I never believed it because his pen is trash, as I've told you, and vocally, importantly, and his beats are trash. So I never bought into that shit, but some of y'all did, right? And so for him to back down is fucking weird. That's the whole point. You've just been talking all this hot shit for literally like a decade, if not more, and especially you've been intensifying that first person shooter. You've been talking this hot shit just yesterday, and now you're going back now? Fraud. So look, the truth of the matter is that Rosenberg is trying to say that, you know, battling is toxic, and you know, again, that's that vulture shit that I don't like, because you're literally trying to unwrite a very important rule in hip-hop. Battling is not toxic, okay? Beef is toxic. And as I said in my previous video on RIP J. Cole, beef and battling are completely different things. Only casuals mix the two together. And yes, sometimes the two things do come together, right? But in general, beef and battling are two totally different things. Battling is musical. It's on wax or, you know, or live, whatever. It is hip hop. It's about testing your skills. That's battles, okay? And beef is, I don't like this person. I have a personal problem with them, okay? Like, I have an issue. I'm, you know, we're going to sort it out, whether with violence or whatever. Those are two different things. Beef is toxic. We don't want beef, but we definitely want battling, okay? So for people to mix the two, and for Rosenberg, who supposedly knows hip hop, to try to make it about beef when it's clearly about battling is pathetic. You know, I will say that, look, at the end of the day, man, this is a phony era, phony rappers playing in the background. And it's just sad, man, because to me, I look at this whole era. This is why sometimes, even me, when I'm making these videos, I'm like, what's the point? You know what I mean? Like, I could spend time talking about how whack rap is. It's so obvious about what makes rap garbage in modern day. And it's really, to be honest with you, with anyone who's listened to rap long enough, we can just tell. I was playing Mussolini and that Ninth Wonder joint that I put y'all onto, or I was talking about in like a few videos past. I was playing it for my boy, and he was just like, yo, this beat's nice. The beat's nice, and Pete Rock's cool, but who is this Mussolini dude? This Mussolini dude is trash. I was like, yes, it's so obvious. He's like, I was listening to this dude. The bars weren't, he weren't saying nothing. The voice was distracting. Yes, he's literally a whack rapper. And they come in all shapes and sizes. There's whack rappers in the mainstream. There's whack rappers, especially in the underground, who posture as real hip-hop rappers but are actually trash. And you're sitting there going like, huh, what do you bring to the table? Why the hell would... Like, who's the audience for this? Because if I'm supposedly a hip-hop fan, a Boom Bap listener, and I've been buying all these Boom Bap listeners and albums, why would I listen to a dude named Mussolini, right? The name is whack. It's like, it's just whack all around. We know. We can tell. Now, again, if you're making it for the new casuals that don't know, that want to pretend like they're into underground rap or whatever, yes, you might be able to fool them. But even they will leave hip-hop eventually, and you'll be stuck with nothing. Like, no classics would have been generated from any of that shit. Listen, when you're that guy, when you're in hip-hop and you are making stuff that really hits people, we know. We all know. We can feel it. And it doesn't even matter what your tastes are. Like, when I talk with my boy, for example, about this, I'm more into the aggressive raw shit. Mobb Deep, Nas, Wu-Tang, all that kind of stuff. He's more into the happy shit, De La, Tribe, all that stuff. And that's cool. But again, all that stuff's dope. All that stuff's hip-hop, right? And even he knows Prodigy. He knows Nas. He knows all that stuff. He knows that stuff's dope. He listens to that shit. Just like I know all that De La stuff, all that Tribe stuff. At the end of the day, when you are him or her, we know, right? You can't fake it. You can't force it. Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, all these whack niggas are trying to force it. And that shit's pathetic, frankly. I think the last thing I want to say, I'll touch on this in a bit. Again, you want to be compared to Jay. You want to be compared to Nas. Of course, every time something stupid happens in hip-hop, someone, the first thing a casual or a vulture reaches to is like, well, what about Nas? When Nas did this or when Jay did this, it's just like, stop. You are not these guys, okay? These guys live and breathe hip-hop. They have made some of the greatest shit this genre has ever seen, okay? Now, I want to talk about this briefly because this record is phenomenal. You already know. You can tell by the beat. The beat is incredible. This is like one of the best Hove beats ever. I've always said this is a top 5 Jay record. Like, this is the kind of shit that you heard from Jay and you went, oh, Jay's taken over. Oh, he's already taken over. He's Thanos. Like, yeah, 1 million, 2 million. Like, he's taken over. And the thing is, what is so brilliant about this record is that it shows this beautiful evolution of a mind's person, like their heart and spirit. This is not a song that Hove could have made on his first album, right? Like, even on the second, it took a while for him to get here. You know what I'm saying? And now he's here and telling you about it. Look, I've conquered rap, and I'm now trying to get on to the next thing. So here, let me tell you what I think. And you're like, oh yeah, let me listen to you. Because this is believable and it's interesting. You know, the problem with modern rap, especially in the last, I would argue, 20 years in particular, is that rappers have not evolved, right? Like, they're making the same songs over and over again. And it's the same tired-like, childlike perspective. And to me, you know, this shit started, in my opinion, with Eminem, because Eminem never evolved. And it's just infected rap since, right? Like, look at Nas' Second Childhood. Second Childhood is a song that Nas couldn't have really made when he came out, because he was closer to, like, 18 or 19 when he made Illmatic. But at the time when he made Second Childhood, he was probably in his early 30s, right? And so he can apply the Illmatic style, that sort of reflective, thoughtful, you know, hard sort of intellect thing that we like about Nas. And he's still going and he's applying that to where he's at that particular time when he was in his early 30s and makes a phenomenal record called Second Childhood. In fact, this is why I love the Lost Tapes in general. And I always say that the Lost Tapes, to me, is the second best Nas album after Illmatic, because it's Illmatic, but like, Nas making that later, if that makes sense. You know, it's Nas 10 years later almost doing Illmatic type shit, right? So, but of course, the whole point is you don't have to change your formula. Like, once we like you for something, once you've figured out your essence and what you're going to bring to the game, your sound, your style, and all that beautiful shit, and it works, keep that shit. Just improve on it. Like, and if you can't improve on it, just keep doing it at a high level. I mean, it's that simple, right? So, you know, this is the kind of stuff that makes someone a legend. You have to be able to consistently put out great material. You don't necessarily have to drop Illmatics all the time, but you do have to put out, like, anytime you record or whatever, every at least couple of years, you got to put out a song that makes people go, yo, this is some of the best shit I've ever heard from this person. And it feels like it's, like, new. It's evolved. It's an evolved version of that person because we want to see people grow. This is why Nas and Jay are legends. They grew with their audience. You know what I mean? I would argue that to a certain degree, I don't think Mobb Deep evolved, and I do think that that harmed them. And I love Mobb Deep, okay? You already know how I feel about Mobb Deep. I think P started to try to evolve later, but by the time he started to evolve, I think it was a little too late, in my opinion. They were just on some murder, kill shit all the time. And I remember thinking that back in the 2000s, where I was like, okay, I love all your shit. I've bought your albums, but I wish you guys would just evolve the subject matter. You know what I mean? And they tried to sprinkle a little bit here and there, but it wasn't as obvious or as sort of as straightforward in a way as Nas. Like, you could tell Nas was evolving. You know what I'm saying? Even though I didn't like Streets Disciple, but you get my point. He wasn't on the corner anymore, right? He wasn't in those Illmatic days. He was an elder statesman. He's now talking about sort of larger societal patterns and stuff that he was already talking about in New York State of Mind, where he was applying those patterns to Queensbridge. And he was just talking about shit that was going on in Queensbridge. Now he's talking about larger societal patterns like Black Zombie, right? Like how black folk are stuck in certain patterns of dysfunction. Or referencing old Egypt, for example, on I Can and trying to, you know, motivate the kids to do better, right? See, this is what I'm saying. You gotta evolve. And we like when people evolve, right? Your new era, these dudes do not evolve, right? You could say that, what's his name, Kendrick Lamar or whatever. Well, Kendrick is whack, so it doesn't apply to him necessarily. But I will give, you know, Kendrick Lamar a little bit of props on this. And again, like I was telling with my peoples, like when we have this conversation, Kendrick has always been the better rapper than J. Cole in a way, because Kendrick actually tries new things, quote unquote, even though it's very tired and very forced. But there is an attempt at creating a larger narrative. Right? Whereas J. Cole is just stuck in a fucking box. Like, you can tell, this dude makes the same songs with the same vibe over and over again. And, you know, that shit's garbage. Lastly, I will give half a bar to the new Future and Metro album. That shit is garbage. I didn't listen to all of it. I won't listen to all of it. I started the first couple of tracks, and I got to I Love Bad Bitches, or whatever that song was, and I was like, nope, I'm not listening to 25 tracks of pure mid. And in fact, I was like, not even listening to the whole song. I was just like, okay, 10 seconds, it sounds boring, boom, next. It's such a waste of my time. So if y'all like the album, if it somehow got so much better, please let me know, and I'll check out those songs. But for right now, I'm going to give that album a complete skip. Okay? Peace. Love y'all.